is same type of construct of triangle ABC in which our angle B 40 degree, angle C 60 degree and AB plus BC plus CA is of 15 cm. Now first you have to draw, then see that the perimeter, how much you have given, 14 cm. That much of length of, you have to draw one horizontal line and take off that of as and take off xy. Okay, because now we have to name triangle as a ABC. You take for this one by any arbitrary name of xy and write off the length of that line, that is 14 cm. Next up, one side up, you take off 40 degree, one side you mark 40 degree, I mark this side 40 degree and another side 60 degree. Okay, keep a protractor middle point at x and mark how much degree, angle x is how much, that is 40 degree. Okay, 10, 20, 30, 40, 40 is your and you join that with the x. Okay, and another side at y you have to mark. You have to mark 60 degree now. Another end, you have to mark 60 degree. Mark 60 degree, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 here. Okay, join that with the y. Now, you have to draw angle bisectors of both. Okay, so you take some length in your compass and keep it x and cut that arms of angle x by an arc like this. Okay, cut off the arms of angle x by an arc, and now the point of intersection of arc and this line that you have to consider for angle bisector. I will highlight this point, and here you have one more point of intersection of this arc and the arm of this angle. Okay, so these two highlighted points you have to consider now to construct an angle bisector. Now keep it one point and draw one arc in between these two lines and keep it another angle and draw one more arc such that it should cut off the previous arc which you draw. Okay, now you join that point of intersection of these two arcs with the x. Okay, next another angle also same that you have to do. Take some length in your compass and keep it y and cut these two lines by an arc. Okay, and take the point of intersection of arc and the arms of this angle. Okay, I highlighted that two points you have to take now. Okay, now keep it one end and draw one arc in between these two lines. Keep it another end and cut off that previous arc which you drawn by one more arc. Okay, and next join that point of intersection of these two arcs with the y. Okay, now these two angle bisectors are not intersecting, so what you have to do is you have to extend both the angle bisectors. Okay, extend, and this one also extend little till they intersect each other, and when they intersect take on that point of intersection as a which point to see which point you have to see these of two these angles B and G is a which vertex is missing, that you have to name for this vertex. Okay, that is A. After that you have to draw a perpendicular bisector of this XA line and AY line. Okay, for that you have to take now XA length. Now we draw a perpendicular bisector of XA line. Take a XA length in your compass and draw one arc above XA and below XA and keep it another end A and draw one more arc below the line XA and one arc above the line XA such that there should intersect each other. Okay, above the line XA and below the line XA. Next you join the point of intersection of that two arcs above and below. After that take AY or YA length in your compass. One tip must be at A and the tip must be at Y. Like that if you keep, then your compass will be with the AY length. Then you draw one arc above YA and below YA. Next repeat the same type by keeping it Y above one arc and below the line YA one arc. Okay, Now you have to join the point of intersection of the two arcs MO and below the line YA. Okay, join that like this. While joining like that, that the perpendicular bisector and this line and XY, they will meet at one point. That point I want to name as, since we marked up that right side of 60 degree, you have to mark off this point as a C, and this perpendicular bisector and the XY line meet at one point. That point you have to mark as point B, because the left side of we marked a 40 degree. Okay, now you have to join up the, you have to join these are two vertices B and C with the vertex of A. Okay, now this is your triangle ABC, and this side of we marked a 40 degree, so you have to write up your 40 degree, and this side we marked a 60 degree, and the perimeter is a 14 centimeter. If your construction is proper, then you will get angle B exactly 40 degree and angle of C 60 degree, or otherwise one more thing also you can do to check out whether construction is proper or not, just to measure AB length and BC length and AC length. If a sum of all these gives you 14 centimeter, then your construction is proper. Otherwise, you have to check your construction scale of pencil and all. Okay, thank you. Next problem is a construct a right triangle whose base is 12 centimeter and sum of its hypotenuse and other side is 18 centimeter. Now you are given base and right angle triangle means you have to take a base angle as a 90 degree. Okay, because you know that right triangle means one angle is 90 degree in that. So you have to take one right angle triangle with the base of 12 centimeter and at one base you have to mark 90 degree, and sum of other two sides, that is hypotenuse and remaining side, is 18 centimeter is given to you. First, what you have to do is you have to draw base, okay, base of length of 12 cm. So, draw a line of length of 12 cm. And I take this as a BC, okay. Now, we have to construct the right angle triangle. Here, base angle is not given to you, okay. So, which base angle you have to take off? For a right angle triangle, you have to take off base angle 90 degree, okay. And to B, you keep your protractor at 0. Or line of BC, mark of 90 degree like this. Okay, then now you join that 90 degree marking, 90 degree marking point with the point of B. Okay, and you extend that line up, and next you have to see sum of other two sides is how much. Sum of other two sides, hypotenuse and other side, is 18 centimeter. Keep your scale on this extended line, so that a zero of a scale must be at the P like this. Okay, and mark the point at the 18 centimeter distance. Here it is that point. Okay, this point is at the 18 centimeter distance from the point of B, and you take this point as a point D, and after that you have to join that point D with the C. Okay, join point D with C, and this is a long enough, so you have to use a lengthy scale to join that up. After that you have to take your compass, okay, and you have to draw perpendicular bisector of a line of CD. See, now CD line is a very big it is not possible to take a full length of a CD in a compass. Okay, it is CD line is a large and it is not comfortable to take a full length of CD in a compass. Okay, so what you have to do is a half of CD, more than half of CD you have to take. Okay, suppose for example a CD is of length of 20 centimeter, then you have to take a more than half of 20, that is more than half of 10 you have to take up in a compass. Okay, I'll take up more than half of CD, okay, in a compass. Somewhere it is here, a midpoint of the CD, okay, not exactly, somewhere here, more than half of CD length you have to take in your compass. Okay, after that keep it C and draw one arc above CD and below. below C. Okay, by keeping it C, you have to draw one arc above and below CD. Okay, what you have to take in your compass? You have to take in your compass more than half of CD length. Okay, and repeat up same type by keeping it D also. One arc above and below. Now, you have to join the point of intersection of these two arcs above and below CD. Okay, so join these two points of intersection. So when you join like this, then this is the perpendicular bisector and this is the line of BD. They are intersecting at one point, okay? Here, suppose you get a line here, you have to extend this perpendicular bisector till that intersect this BD line, okay? So here I got the point of intersection of this perpendicular bisector and BD line, and that point you take as A, and you join that A with the C, okay? Join that A with the C. Now this is your right angle triangle with the base of 12 cm and sum of other two sides is 18 cm. If your construction is proper, then you will get this AB plus AC is equal to 18 cm. Okay? Otherwise you have to check your construction. Thank you. Next problem is construct an equilateral triangle given its base. Equilateral triangle means what? Equilateral triangle means a triangle with all sides equal. Okay, so like that you have to draw one triangle now. So given its base, given its side, you take any one side, you draw one line of any length you can take up. Okay, after that take off that length, how much length line you draw, that much length you have to take in your compass, okay? And you mark this point as A, this point as B. Take that line as A, okay? How much length AB has, that much length you have to take in your compass. After that, keep it A and draw one arc above AB like this. In between A and B, above AB. And keep it B and draw one more arc above AB. So that occurs the previous arc which you draw. Okay, now take that point as a point C. Okay, point of intersection of two arcs, you take that as C and join that C with A and C with B. Okay, now this is the equilateral triangle of and take this as a and measure how much this has. This has a 13 units in this scale, okay, 13 cm I'll take, and now this is also same length 13 cm, and this length is also same 13 cm, okay. And one more equilateral triangle, you take any one side, I'll take one side of length 10 cm, okay. I draw one line of length 10 cm and I'll take off that line as XY. Okay, now how to construct a triangle with this 10 cm? How to construct a equilateral triangle with the side of 10 cm? Suppose a 10 cm line is there, you have to take up that length in your compass like this, and next by keeping it up x, you have to draw one arc above x, y line, and by keeping it y also, you have to draw one more arc above x, y. So that shifted the previous arc which you draw. Okay, and take this point of intersection as a z. Next, join that point z with x and with the y. Now this is a equilateral triangle. If you measure this x z and z y length, if your construction is proper, then you will get both are equal to 10 cm each. Okay, thank you.